So let's define that a little more precisely. So we're going to find our set of messages is strings of zeros and ones, so we'll use bits, and of some fixed length. So n is a number that gives us the maximum length of a message. Our message is selected from all binary strings of length n. Our key is also selected from the set of all binary strings of length n. And then to do encryption, our encryption function, we're going to think of the message as being the sequence of bits, and the key is also a sequence of bits. The result of our encryption is the ciphertext, which is a sequence of bits, also length n, where the value of each ciphertext bit is equal to the XOR of the corresponding message bit and the corresponding key bit. So let's try an example. And for this example, I'm going to give you the ciphertext and the key and the message. So suppose our message is the string CS, but our message space is in bits. Well, the first thing we need to do is to convert those strings to bits. And we can do that in Python by using ORD that takes a one character string and turns it into a decimal number. And then we need to convert that decimal number into bits, into a binary number. And we need to do this for each character in the string. We're going to convert it to a character, convert that to bits. And I'll show you the code for doing that. We'll leave the more interesting code for you to write. Here, we're converting to bits. This is a fairly straightforward, but not the shortest way to do this. We're going to make an array of bits as our result. For any decimal number, if it's divisible by 2, we want to have a 0 at the beginning of our result. If it's not divisible by 2, that's going to be a 1. And then we divide the number by 2 as we go forward. So that's going to fill up all the places. We want our bits to be particular lengths, so we have a padding. And for all the characters, we'll use 7 bits. So we're going to pad the result with leading zeros until we get to that size. We could see this. So if we do ORD, we see that the number corresponding to the letter C is 67. If we convert that to bits, and we'll use 7 as our padding, that gives us enough for 128 different values, which is enough for the ASCII character values that we get back from ORD. We can see those bits as a list, and we can see that a little more easily as a string using the display bits procedure that just turns that into a string. So now we want to convert more than one character. To do that, we have a string to bits procedure that goes through all the characters in the string, converting each one to bits using convert to bits and concatenating those all together to the result. So now we can do string to bits for our two-letter string, and now we get 14 bits as a result. So if that's our message, then the value of m is what we got there. So this is our message. There are 14 bits. N is 14. That means to encrypt this using a one-time pad, we need a key that also has 14 bits. So let's pick our key. And we're just going to make up a random key now. Actually, finding random values is very important in cryptography, and we'll talk about that in a later unit. But for now, let's just make one up. So suppose this is our key. Then the ciphertext is just the result of XORing each message bit with the corresponding key bit. So that's our ciphertext. So the question is, as an interceptor, you saw just this ciphertext. You don't know anything about the message or the key. And you're going to guess possible key values to try to figure out what the message is. And what key value would you guess that would mislead you to think that the message was actually BS instead of CS?